Welcome, my brothers and sisters, to the God Minute. It's July the 7th, Random Wednesday, and today we'll be reflecting on another spiritual work of mercy. Thank you for joining us today in prayer. Let us begin as we do all things, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips,
and my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 34, The Way to Happiness. I feel as if I could never cease praising God. Come and rejoice with me over His goodness.
I reached for Him out of my inner conflicts, and He was there to give me strength and courage. I wept in utter frustration over my troubles, and He was near to help and support me.
What He has done for me, He can do for you. Turn to Him. He will not turn away from you. His loving presence encompasses those who yield to Him.
Listen to me. I know whereof I speak. I have learned through experience that this is the way to happiness. Lean on God. Open to Him all that is you, and He will meet your emptiness with His abundance and bring you peace.
Glory be to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Today I want to share a reflection on the spiritual work of mercy to instruct the ignorant. Now, some may hear this and think how uncharitable it is to think of others as ignorant. It does have a negative connotation in our culture, and it's seen as an insult. Unfortunately, we can sometimes approach practicing the spiritual work in a way that supports this line of thinking. But that's not what this work of mercy is about. We should remember first, it's a spiritual work of mercy. Mercy. This is not a spiritual work of pride or of vanity. It's an action of mercy. When we instruct others, we do so out of love for them and for God, not out of love for ourselves. Everyone is ignorant to some degree. The truths that God has revealed to humanity in our faith are like an infinite ocean. Nobody can possibly grasp everything. Nobody is perfect. However, everyone has dignity. Everyone has dignity because we are all made in the image and likeness of God. When we live out this spiritual work of mercy, we are acknowledging other people's dignity. Some people may think that it's better just to let people believe what they believe because we don't want to ruffle feathers or offend anyone. But this goes against God's plan for human dignity. God created everyone to know, love, and serve Him. We never have the right to decide that someone else does not have this same dignity or that someone else is not worthy of this calling. I think back to a time when one of my friends was consistently missing Mass on Sundays. This friend would make it to Mass maybe 2 Sundays out of the month. I didn't want to say anything initially because I didn't want to be offensive or come off as holier than thou. But eventually, this friend stopped going to Mass altogether. I prayed about it, and eventually I sat down with this friend and explained the reasoning behind our quote-unquote Sunday obligation. We talked, we looked in Scripture and the Catechism, and we read what the saints had to say about this. By God's grace, we went to reconciliation together, and my friend started to return to Mass. Living out this spiritual work of mercy takes courage, and most of all, it takes charity. We must love others because of our love for God and because of His plan of goodness for everyone. Everyone deserves to be told the truth in a loving way. So my hope is that we all can hear the call of the Lord to live out this work of mercy in our lives, no matter who we feel called to bring the truth to, that we would always respond to God's call out of recognition for their dignity, but also to approach them with reverence and charity and respect. So I ask, please consider getting involved in your parish as a catechist, an RCIA sponsor, religious education teacher, a youth ministry or marriage preparation mentor, or whatever capacities your parish can provide to live this work of mercy. It is absolutely one of the most rewarding ways that God nurtures our faith. Let the name of Jesus be praised, both now and forever. Amen.
Gathering our prayer and our praise into one, we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Father God, show us your mercy so that we may treat our brothers and sisters with mercy, compassion, and great love. Help us to witness and to intentionally reach out to our brothers and sisters in proclaiming the good news of Jesus Christ. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May he look upon you with kindness and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thanks, everyone, for joining us in prayer today. Take good care of yourself and one another, and we'll see you tomorrow.